Becky Liggero, and we are at the Sands Expo in Las Vegas to bring you the highlights from G2E 2017. We spent the day on the expo floor to check out the latest in innovation of casino games, booth design, and of course, everyone's favorite, the old celebrity appearance. Every has a gigantic booth this year with dozens of slot games to admire. It took 2 years to develop the Penn & Teller themed slot, and we'll let you hear from the legends themselves about the story behind it.
Yeah, been a while. We love working with the guys. You know, one of the things we wanted to do was do some things that were a little goofy, but still stay within the form. And we have a lot of, you know, we did a lot of the stuff that we've, tricks we've done that we've been known for, built into this slot machine.
I love it. So, Teller, you want to give me some hand motions to tell me how the work was for you? On the expo floor, we bumped into the Steve Wynn of slots, Joe Kamenkoff, the creator of slot brands such as Wheel of Fortune, Sex and the City, and Game of Thrones. We discussed how branded slots have managed to hold their appeal to consumers year after year.
People are always looking for that next new thing. It's sort of like a movie theater on a Friday night. Everybody goes in and they want to see what's the next comedy or what's the next horror film or what's the next drama. And that's no different than slot machines, right? Everyone has their own segmentation of what they're interested in. So you can't make something for everyone any longer.
Aristocrat is an industry leader in the land-based casino space. Roberto Coppola talked us through Aristocrat's internal innovation accelerator, Think Bigger, and what the response has been from G2E delegates.
The response from the operators who have been covering our booth and have been checking out our games has been overwhelming. So we have a virtual reality product, we have an augmented reality product, really receptive to that. Not only the fact that we're doing these types of concepts, but the fact that this program exists and is encouraging innovation throughout the company and industry, there's a tremendous response to that as well.
Continuing on with the theme of video game gambling this year, Gamblet's booth had a huge display of their new gamblified Pac-Man game. Marcus Yoder elaborated on the appetite for gamification on the casino floor.
It's been fantastic. It really has been fantastic. You know, early on, maybe a year and a half ago, we talked about the coalition of the willing, you know, the first movers. Now pretty much everybody's in part of the coalition of the willing. So people are ready to experiment with these games. The first two games that we brought to market were in Nevada, we're in Oklahoma, California. And the key aspect is that we made these for younger players, and 65% of our game players are 21 to 39.
The third day of G2E 2017 did not disappoint. We enjoyed our time on the expo floor today. Check back with us tomorrow with our highlights from the fourth and final day of the show, and thank you for watching. This is Becky Liggero for CalvinAyre.com.